What's up, guys? Jeff Cavalier, AthleanX.com. Today we are talking about the traps and how to make sure that you are not messing up your trap training when you're doing it. But before we start, I want to ask you a quick word association question, right? If I name a muscle, what pops into your mind visually? If I said biceps, what pops into your mind? Probably this, right? And what if I said chest? This is a chest. I think we're all probably 2 for 2. If I said shoulders, I think we're probably now 3 for 3. If I said traps, what would you think? Would you think this? Because if you do, that's part of the big problem that we have right here. Because this is not the traps. This is part of the traps. These are the upper traps. And in order to have a fully developed back, and more importantly, a fully functional back, you need to make sure that you're training the rest of this. And as a matter of fact, the larger portion of this, that's the middle trap and the lower traps. See, the traps are a kite-like muscle shaped like this. And when you train them in all portions of them, your shoulders can work more efficiently and effectively. And I want to make sure that you do that at all times. Now, the upper traps are what gets most of the attention because it's what stands up here and makes us look like we're bigger. We have a bigger neck, the whole deal. But I actually don't really program a lot of direct upper trap work into our programs. I don't have a lot of direct upper trap work here on our channel because we can basically target this area of the traps pretty efficiently with some of our big compound movements, the things that form the foundation of what we do. A heavy deadlift is certainly going to overload the traps, especially if you go a little bit wider on your grip. We know that a row can certainly overload the traps, as you can see here. We know that carries are an effective way to load the traps a little bit more for endurance, but they're another way to load the traps. And we build those into the foundation of everything we do. So you don't necessarily need to have a lot of upper trap work. As a matter of fact, what happens is when you start to overdo your trap work, you start to create muscle imbalance. You start to create a dominant forward shoulder. You start to create posture problems. You start to create related weaknesses throughout your shoulder because of this dominance here. So what we want to do, upper cross syndrome, guys, we don't want to go down that path. We want to make sure we're focusing on the other stuff. So what we want to do is start incorporating other exercises. Now, guys, I'm going to make this very, very easy for you. You're not going to have to do 10 more exercises. All right. The first thing you're going to want to do is you want to hit the middle traps. This is the best way I know how to do it. This is a wraparound row. And all you're going to do is you're going to grab the left handle with a right hand and the right handle with the left hand. And you don't need to even have cables or handles here. You can do this with bands. But you're going to want to keep your elbows in tight to your body. And you wrap around and keep your elbow around and tight, trying to retract the scapula. And we could do it in a lot of different cadences and sequences, as you see here. I could do one arm at a time. I could hold one in contraction while I bring the other one around. I could actually do both at the same time. That's all more of a preference of how you do it and how you can feel it more effectively. But the concept is in keeping the moment arm here short by not going out this way and bring our arms out into a T, which is a middle trap exercise, we're actually removing a lot of the rear delt from that movement because we shorten that. We take that rear delt out a lot more. We don't make it that much more difficult to achieve and to get to the area we're actually trying to work on. So if we keep it short and wrap in tight, we're going to get more of that scapular retraction driven by the middle trap. And this is what I want you to do. Include some of those exercises when you do train your traps. If you're going to do a shrug, a classic shrug like this, make sure you're doing at least a little bit of middle trap work with it. One for one. Give me one set for every set you do of your shrugs. Now, the lower traps, incredibly important for the motion and proper motion of the shoulder as you raise it up over your head. We want to work the lower trap here with this exercise. This is a prone press. Now you're going to find here, it's very humbling, you don't need to have a lot of weight to do this exercise. Matter of fact, some people will find that just doing the motion alone is all they need to overload this portion because it's a chronically weak portion of the traps. As I mentioned, we don't even visualize it, let alone train it. So we want to make sure we do that and you do some lower trap work. Now, here's the best part about this. If you've been watching my channel for any length of time, if you knew how much I value the face pull, you'd be doing face pulls after every single workout. Right? You're listening to me, you're doing your face pulls every time you train. If you do the face pull, there's a slight modification you can make to make this exercise hit the middle trap and the lower trap even more effectively. And you do this. You do a face pull with this elevated raise at the end. And all you have to do is, again, take that pull back, same mechanics, proper mechanics of a face pull. You lead with the hands. Right? Don't lead with the elbows, because if you lead with the elbows, you're going to go into internal rotation of the shoulder. You want to create external rotation and get the shoulder working with the rotator cuff and the mid-scap muscles, all of them working together the way they prefer to. So we lead with the hands back, and then what we do is from here, we keep it there and raise our arms up over our head. Now, the force is pulling our arms this way, All those that whether you're using bands or whether you're using cables, is pulling my hands out in front of my body. I have to work hard to keep myself retracted, but now I'm combining that retraction with the elevation and going through the whole range of motion. We're gonna hit the middle traps, we're gonna hit those lower traps, and of course, the face pull itself is good for hitting the upper traps as well. So if you kinda wanna go for that little faster route, do the face pulls as always, add this slight tweak to it, and you're gonna really get done everything I need you to get done. So guys, hopefully you have a better appreciation of the traps, and the next time someone says, hey, what are the traps? You'll draw that whole picture mentally in your mind of that entire kite, upper, middle, and lower, and make sure you get it right every time in your training. If you're looking for programs, guys, that don't overlook any muscle, because they all matter, we do that for you guys step by step in our programs over at athletenx.com. In the meantime, if you found this video helpful, leave your comments and thumbs up below. Let me know what else you want me to cover, and I'll do that for you in future videos. And if you haven't already done so, guys, please subscribe and turn on your notifications so you never miss a video when we do it. All right, guys, see you soon.